Black creators have undeniably defined mainstream culture. Their artwork has entertained, made social commentary, and inspired. Black artists celebrate their Blackness through art, fashion, music, and dance. Black artists have made countless contributions to the American mainstream. The question still lingers as to where to draw the line between appropriating Black culture and appreciating it. One of the first transformative periods for the creation and expression of Black art occurred in the 1920s and was known as the Harlem Renaissance. The Harlem Renaissance was one of the first social catalysts in African American history and provided several opportunities for Black people to excel in the arts.
And there's me, excuse my crust. Introduce myself.
Musicians that came out of the Harlem Renaissance, like Louis Armstrong and Billie Holiday, attracted people from other communities as their sounds grew in popularity. Among other notable examples of Black culture thriving in the Harlem Renaissance was Black Swan Records. Founded in 1921 by Harry Pace, Black Swan was the first record label to be owned, operated, and marketed by African Americans. As the social scene in Harlem thrived, African American performers created dances such as the Lindy Hop, which emerged in the 1920s from performance halls like the historic Savoy Ballroom. The Lindy Hop was a social dance that was often improvised, and people generally learned it from watching each other. Over time, as ballroom performances dwindled, the creators of the dance and the history behind it was less well known. Finally, in the 1950s, the Lindy Hop was renamed the Jitterbug. One of the earliest forms of appropriation in entertainment was during the 19th century, when African Americans were used as comedic characters played by white people in blackface. Minstrel performer T.D. Rice gained popularity after commercializing a dance he copied from an enslaved man whom he saw dancing on a plantation. His performances were immensely popular amongst white audiences. But with the attraction of these newfound sounds, quickly became a marketable sensation for the mainstream.
Serving USA.
Economic exploitation called for Black entrepreneurs to take back this marketable phenomenon. Berry Gordy was the founder of the Motown record label, which was the highest earning African-American business for decades. Gordy saw the future more clearly, in which Black musicians would participate in the mainstream alongside their white counterparts and be paid for the work they produced. As new school hip-hop emerged in the mid-1980s, groups like Run-DMC combined hard rock with rap. Public Enemy rapped about Black political ideology, and N.W.A. would rap about their experience living in the inner city. Contrary to Gordy, hip-hop and rap music primarily aimed to bring awareness to the Black experience. During this time, hip-hop was a musical genre that allowed Black people to share their raw emotions toward an unjust system and create solidarity. However, the genre's political messages were altered in the early 90s to become more digestible for white audiences. Two decades later, artists like Macklemore were recognized by institutions like the Grammys. While the Grammys acknowledge Black artists in categories that are synonymous with Black music, such as hip-hop and R&B, Black musicians are frequently overlooked for Best New Artist, as well as Album, Record, and Song of the Year. Black dancers have faced similar challenges in the fight to be acknowledged and compensated for their artistic works. Without coverage from the New York Times, 14-year-old Jalea Harmon might not have gotten credit for her viral TikTok dance, The Renegade, which was thought to be popularized by influencer Charli D'Amelio. With rapper 2 Milly, his viral dance, The Milly Rock, was stolen and resold to players of the popular video game Fortnite, all without credit or compensation. In 2018, 2 Milly filed a lawsuit against Epic Games, the makers of Fortnite, for exploiting his work. Throughout African American history, resistance has been a recurring theme in all aspects of life. Black culture is the culmination of creativity and resilience. It is a shared experience birthed in survival that today manifests itself in many tangible forms. The lines of culture are blurry. But as Black culture continues to be mainstreamed, it is important to not erase the people, history, and experiences tied to the content we love so much.